If I said words like dilation, reflection, transformation, rotation, would you know what I mean? No, I'm not rapping. These are words that come under the umbrella of geometry. Let's get into some geometry right now. So this first question is to do with the transformation. Let's get right into this one. Triangle A and triangle B are graphed on the coordinate plane. So this is a coordinate plane with all the coordinates. You have the y-axis, which is vertical. Then you have the x-axis, which is horizontal. And you can see the numbers going from the center away, minus side on the x, minus side on the y, plus side on the x, plus side on the y. So here you have triangle A, and this is what they want to know to do with it. So which sequence of transformations, let me move this up again, which sequence of transformations will map triangle A onto its congruent image, triangle B? Congruent just means same shape, same size. All right, so here you have the choices, and I'm going to go through them individually so you can see which one matches. So we're going to be going back and forth so we can have a good look at what's happening here. So here you have triangle A. All right, so choice A is a reflection over the x-axis, then a reflection over the y. So they're saying, is this a reflection over the A, then a reflection over the Y? Well, let's take a look more deeply at it, right? So a reflection over the X, let's count it. So from this line here, you have two squares away, right? So here you're going to have two squares away for this point here, right? So we're going to count 1, 2. So we're going to plot it here on the plane. And then we're looking at this one. So you have 1, 2 away. So it should be 1, 2 away. So it's going to be here. Right? So we're looking to see if this is a reflection over the X. So here, when you count it, you are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 points away. And we're going to do the same thing going down here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it plots here. So by the time you link it all up, right, this is giving you, is this a reflection? Okay, yeah, it's a reflection of this triangle, but then the second part of choice A said a reflection over the Y. Now, if you was to look and you was to reflect it, I mean, I could have visually looked at this to see if it could be reflected over the x-axis, right? So this is a reflection over the X, but a reflection over the Y would not be like this, right? You'd have to switch it over, right? So then the hypotenuse, or the slanted, the longest side of the triangle would be on the other side if it was reflected, wouldn't it? Right? Okay. So a translation 8 units down, then a reflection over the Y. So let's see. Let's have a look at that. A translation 8 units down. Well, we already established that this is not 8 units, right? So each point is not 8 units. This was 4, this was 2 to get here, and this was 6. So immediately the first half of choice B is doesn't match, right? So let's look at C. A reflection over the x-axis, which we already did, then a translation 6 units to the left. All right, so a translation then is when you count over, right, 6 units to the left according to the corresponding points, right? So if I was to go here and count 6 units over to the left, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, that corresponds. And then this one, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, that corresponds. And then this one, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So that all corresponds to the triangle being exactly the same way, right, as the reflection over the X, and then 6 units translated to the left. That's what shifted the triangle over here to make B. So for this choice, I'm not even gonna do D because I don't wanna make this video long, right? So this answer is C, right? Because it is a reflection over the X, then it translated 6 units to the left. For this one, you have rectangle ABCD with the apostrophes here. So this rectangle is similar to rectangle ABCD, right? So you see the difference here and here, right? So this rectangle ABCD is similar to rectangle ABCD as shown on the coordinate plane. So this is the whole coordinate plane. Now, here are the questions. Which sequence of transformations maps rectangle ABCD onto rectangle ABCD? Right, so here we are. We're gonna take them one at a time. So a translation 8 units to the left, then a dilation. Dilation, usually when we think of the word dilation, we usually think of the shape or whatever it is getting bigger. It's usually associated with our pupils and our eyes, right? And it will get bigger, but in math, under the umbrella of geometry, dilation can mean either. It can mean an expansion to get bigger, or it can mean a reduction or a shrinkage to be smaller, right? So then a dilation by a scale factor of a half. Scale factor of a half means if you multiply the coordinates by a half. Let's have a look. So first of all, we need to see the plots, right? So you plot, when you read it, you say x, y, x comes before the y. So when you look at A, on the X is 2 and on the Y is 4. So this is 2, 4. Let's look at B. B is 6, 4. So we're gonna write that there, 6, 4. C is 6, 2. So we're gonna put 6, 2 underneath this one. And then D is 2, 2. Right, so it's always in the order, X first, then the Y, right? Just think of XYZ or XYZ, right? And you'll be able to remember the order in the same order as the ABC, okay? Now, if it is choice A said a dilation by a scale factor of a half, that means if you was to multiply each of these by a half, which just simply means to half each of them, right? Said, but if you look at the A, B, C, D, A is over to the left and B is over to the right. But on this rectangle A, B, C, D, the A is flipped, right? So automatically you're going to know that it's not A, right? Why? Because this the rectangles are not translated, right? They're not translated over. This is not a translation, because if it was, the A would be in the same position as it is over here. So we're eliminating choice A. We're looking at choice B right now, and it's saying a reflection over the y-axis, then a dilation by a scale factor of half. Well, so what we have to do then is we also have to look at the plots for this smaller rectangle ABCD. So this one is minus 1 on the X, remember it's XY, minus 1, 2. So we're gonna put that there. This one for B is minus 3, 2. So we're gonna put that there. C is minus 3, 1. And D is minus 1, 1. Right? So let's see if it is a scale factor of a half, because that is multiplied by a half, which means that you're just basically halving the coordinates, right? So if we look, right, if A is 2, 4, then this is going to be the flip side, right? So half of 2 is 1, but because it's on this side, it's going to be minus 1, 2, right? And that's what it is, yes? Okay. So B should be minus 3, 2, which it is. C would be minus 3, 1, which it is. And D would be minus 1, 1, right? Because it's flipped on this side. So each of the X coordinates are going to be minus a half of the numbers that's in the on the original coordinates. So that goes, right? So it's definitely a reflection, right? It's a reflection because we know that it goes the other way. It's been flipped, right? So it's definitely a reflection, and it's definitely a dilation, a dilation by a scale factor of a half, right? So we definitely know it's that. But the reason why I'm gonna automatically eliminate C and D is because here these both say 90 degree counterclockwise rotation, right? Now in England, for my English viewers, we say anti-clockwise, but that just means the other way of the way the clock goes, right? Clock goes this way, counterclockwise or anti-clockwise goes the other way, right? So we automatically know that it's not these two because it's not doing a rotation, a counterclockwise rotation from here to here, right? Or the other way around, right? So they wanted to know the transformation from the larger one to the smaller one, and it's definitely B, right? Because you can see it's definitely a reflection and it's definitely a scale factor of a half, right? Center dilation of the origin. Origin is here, right? So the dilation of the origin came from these original coordinates. So this answer is B. This question is asking, so look at triangle ABC is graphed on the coordinate plane. So it says triangle ABC is dilated by a scale factor of 2, right? So because it's a whole number, that means it is bigger, right? With a center of dilation at the origin to create ABCD, which would be the other triangle that's going to sit on the same plane as the original one here. What are the coordinates of the vertices of ABC, which is the new one, right? The new one. So we have our choices here. So first of all, let's find out what the coordinates are of this original one that they have here. So the point A is 2, 2, right? So remember it's X, then the Y. So it's 2, 2. So we're going to put that there. B, plot B is 4, 4. And then plot C is minus 4, 2, right? Remember X, Y, minus 4, 2, minus 4, 2. Now, because it's, because this is dilated by a scale factor of 2, they want to know what are the coordinates of the vertices A, B, C. So let's put the coordinates here, right? So we got A, B, C. Right? So A is 2, 2, B is 4, 4, C is minus 4, 2. Just to remind us of what they are, right? Because it goes right next to the choices here. So with the choices here, we're looking at the given answers here, right? So if this is dilated by a scale factor of 2, right, the center of dilation at the origin, origin is here, to create this new triangle. So we want to know what are the coordinates of this new triangle, right? So scale factor of 2 is the most significant part of the question. Scale factor of 2 meaning you are multiplying by 2, right? So if we multiplied these by 2, 2 times 2, this would give a 4, 4, right? This would give, what would this give? 2 times 4, 2 times 4, right? This would give an 8, 8. And what would this give, right? 2 times 4 is 8, so minus 4 would be a minus 8. We've still got to keep the minus. And then 2 times 2 is 4, right? So we're looking at that, scale factor of 2. So then, remember, scale factor of 2 could mean dilation. As I said before, dilated is either a reduction or an enlargement. Right? So then when we look at that, scale factor of 2 means we multiply these coordinates by 2. And then what matches here? Right? So we're looking for a 4, 4 first. B starts, C starts with a 4, 4, and so does D. Okay? So then you go to the next one, 8, 8. See? Definitely not there. So we have an 8, 8 here. And let's do the last one, minus 8, 4, minus 8, 4. Definitely D. So it would look like this. So these are the coordinates of the vertices with the new triangle ABC, right? So you have the A is 4, 4, B is 8, 8, and point C is minus 8, 4. So I hope that helped and it shed more light onto the coordinate plane and all those other words that comes underneath the umbrella of geometry. Let me know what you think about this video. Like, comment, and subscribe with that notification bell so you'll know every time I upload, which is every Wednesday. And I will see you next time in another math video. Thank you for watching. Class dismissed.